Dzień dobry, Doki. Infiltrator powrócił, jak widać. Ostatni odcinek to ukazał.
Apparently Skynet's got a real hard on for you. So we figured why not use you as bait.
Aren't you afraid that Skynet will bring a lot of firepower if they know we're both here?
Afraid? No. Prepared for that eventuality? Yes. We've got eyes on the ambush site from every angle. If anyone shows up, it means they were listening.
What if it's one of our guys, or just a scavenger?
Too bad. We can't have anyone or anything sabotage our plan. Not this time.
This time?
We were very close once before. For years, we've been preparing for the final attack. But it took just one man to fuck everything up. That day, Perry, our previous field commander, died, and I inherited control of South Division. Since then, I've been making sure that no one fucks up again.
We've got movement.
Take position. What do you have?
A hooded man's walking down the street. Might be a scavenger.
Rivers, you saw him. Is it the same model? Is it the infiltrator?
Tak.
I can't tell. I think that might be it.
You think?
Good enough for me.
Cease fire! Cease fire! Target down! I repeat, target down!
Go check him!
Coś trochę za łatwo poszło.
Proceed with caution!
Is he dead?
Fuck! It's the target!
He can't get away! Fire at will!
O, dzień dobry panu.
In the open. It's a fucking machine.
Trochę silne. Dawaj go.
It's carrying a second generation plasma rifle. I want it.
O, myślę, że to. Myślałem, że ta beczka wybuchnie, ale jednak się trochę przeliczyłem. Jezus, przecież ja całą amunicję stracę, jak to tak będzie wyglądać. Gdzie on jest? No wychyl tą łeb brzydką. Jaki take cover, dawaj go. Ohohohoho, okej.
Open fire! That's one ugly son of a bitch.
Ups. Ups. No.
Not again. Follow it.
Za późno się skapłem, że są właśnie te wybuchające beczki i tak dalej. O, skubany dynamitem rzuca. Ciekawe, czy mógłbym mu wrąbać miecz ten, to znaczy ten nóż elektryczny w plecy. Gdzie on jest? Tutaj. Ja pierniczę, jeszcze nie trafiłem. Ups. O, coś się zwiesiło. Nie na szybko. Raczej nie na długo. Boże, co ja gadam. No i... O, w końcu.
We got it. We finally got it.
Good job, Rivers. Stay there. We're on our way.
Schron ruchu oporu. Infiltrator został zniszczony. Jego pancerz bojowy z hiperstopu był wytrzymalszy niż wszystko inne, z czym do tej pory mieliśmy do czynienia. Ledwo daliśmy radę jednemu, z całą armią bylibyśmy bez szans. Jednak tym, co czyniło infiltratora najgroźniejszą bronią, Skynet to była jego skóra.
There was no doubt anymore. Skynet had created a cybernetic organism. It was designed to blur the line between a man and a machine. People started to think that there were terminators amongst us. Wolves in sheep's clothes. Some of us left, even though we hadn't seen any other infiltrators yet. Or at least, we didn't think we had. And that fear of not knowing was what turned the tide of this war. That night, Skynet won.
I still have to run some tests, so for now, I would say no.
We need some more time, Connor.
I know you don't want to hear this, Commander, but if there's one person who can help us, it's Dr. Mack.
Mack? We don't even know if he's alive.
He is. He's in the Hollywood Hills. We knew a time would come when we'd need him again, so we've kept an eye on him.
Wait. You've been watching him without telling me?
You let your emotions cloud your judgment before, Commander. That's why I decided that Mack's whereabouts were no longer
this
your
is
concern.
Bullshit. He can't just magically fix all of our problems. He's a man, not a god. A man that makes
that's
mistakes.
Enough, Commander.
You know what happened last time. He's the reason Perry's dead.
I said that's enough. Sergeant Rivers?
Yes, sir.
TechCom believes that being marked for termination is a badge of honor. A sign that we're doing something right. We wear it proudly. And knowing you're wearing such a badge, Rivers, is all I need to trust you with handling this mission. Commander Baron will fill you in on the details. Good luck, soldier. Over and out.
Looks like you're going to Hollywood Hills. Dr. Edwin Mack is the one who taught us how to use Skynet's weapons, so there's a chance he can do it again. Take him that second-generation plasma rifle and see if he's able to reprogram it. If we want to use Skynet's weapons, we need to bypass their encryption lockouts.
How will I find him?
He's obsessed with surveillance. So when you get there, look for any cameras, biometric sensors, or any other tech stuff. He should be around. That's it.
Misja wykonana. Polowanie.
What do you need?
Was Mac the one whose drone you smashed?
Yes. Yes, it was. I've never told this to anyone, but before I met Mac and Perry, I was wandering alone. Didn't have a map, so I drew one myself. The first people I came across were two guys, old enough to remember Judgment Day. We camped out together. They gave me advice, we shared some stories. Sounds nice, right?
See, there are still good people out there.
They weren't good. Although, not cutting my throat in my sleep makes them more or less gentlemen. When I woke up, all my things were gone, including my map. There I was, lost in the desert. Thirst and hunger. I knew I was gonna die. I passed out with my face in the sand. But next thing, I was lying in a bed, bathed and wearing clean clothes.
You're lucky someone found you.
Someone did find me. Too bad it was Skynet. Through the window, I saw thousands of Terminators. First, I thought it was a work camp. But it was something else. A Skynet research facility. They kept me alive, but I didn't know why. I thought I was the only human there. But after a while, someone came into my cell. A man. Well-dressed, clean-shaven. You want to take a guess who that was?
One of those guys who robbed you?
No. He was a traitor to his race. Bastard was selling every piece of knowledge the machines didn't have. In return, they gave him everything he wanted. When he was done stuffing his face with food, he had another request. He wanted a whore. It lasted months until I got to wrap a towel around his neck and make his eyes pop. You don't want to see people for what they really are. I've seen their true face. That traitor, those two guys in the desert, Mac. They all showed it to me. It's not pretty. The truth is, the only reason I fight for the Resistance is because I despise people just a little less than the machines.
Anything I should know about Dr. Mac before I leave?
No, but filozofia.
That he can't be trusted, and he's highly manipulative. So you need to stay cautious.
Okej. Odsuń się. Mogę go ubrać? A nie, chyba nie bardzo. Znaczy założyć, ubrać i tak dalej. Zwał jak zwał. Używać.
I've heard that you're going to Hollywood Hills. Well, with Baron yelling like that, the whole shelter heard. He wanted me to tell you if I needed anything, so here it is. When you get to Hollywood Hills, could you stop by my old house? It's near the Griffith Park tennis courts. I wonder if Peter went there and left something for me. I know he'd be stupid to go there since now it's behind the Annihilation line, but then again, he was always full of stupid ideas.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
Nie ma za co, Erin.
Look at him.
Ej, mogę z nią porozmawiać? Nie, nie, tak, mogę, ale to później. Muszę iść tam. O.
Jacob. What happened after you started your camp?
Honestly, not that much. At least not in the beginning. When we gave up on the idea of getting in touch with anyone, we just tried to adapt. Temperatures fell, we had to scavenge for food. All of a sudden, that became our life.
Hmm.
When did you first hear about Skynet?
Oh, that came years later. We did hear some rumors about robot warriors, but you must understand how crazy it sounded back then. And that wasn't even the most insane story out there. My favorite one was about the radioactive rural zombies. Well, I know how stupid it sounds, but we managed to have fun in our little commune. I still have my guitar with me. We talked a lot about how we're gonna be famous, because we're the only living band in the world.
You played in a band?
I did. One of the few things I was better at than Tucker. He didn't have much talent, but he loved the idea of sex, drugs, and rock and roll, especially the first two. We were just stupid kids, not realizing what was going on. We paid the price for it the first time we saw a tin can. I was tuning my guitar when I heard a strange noise. I found out later that it was a T-400. Must have heard me play. It didn't even have the decency to look scary. Maybe if it did, we wouldn't have just stood there when it started firing.
400 to chyba jeden z pierwszych.
What did you do?
I froze. I didn't run to help. I didn't scream. I didn't even move. I just stood there, like a coward. A tin can got Tucker with a single bullet. Bam, just like that. Seven other people died before we finally destroyed that thing. Ironically enough, I was the one who delivered the final blow. Safe to say, it was the beginning of a new era.
Earlier, you said that a new era started. What changed?
Well, for one thing, with Tucker dead, I became the new leader of the group. Something I never expected or wanted, for that matter.
Did everyone agree that you should be the new leader?
Not everyone. We had a huge fight about food, where we should go next,
and so on.
Our group divided without Tucker to keep it together. I was terrified. I started to walk away like I was on autopilot. I don't know if I wanted to run away or to kill myself, but then something surreal happened. I found a metal door in the ground in the middle of nowhere.
Hmm?
I was real unsure about what I might find under it, but what I did find was the aftermath of a massacre.
More Terminators?
That's exactly what I thought at first, but it turned out to be something even more scary. It looked like they decided to commit suicide. I couldn't understand it. To me, they had
everything.
They even had a case of beer. So, I got shit-faced and started crying over my brother's death. But I realized something. I realized I could maybe survive there.
Did you come back to tell everyone?
I did. After I buried the bodies outside, I returned to the camp with the good news.
Jakbyście wiedzieli prawdę.
After that, we were all right. That night, I learned two things. Firstly, that it's okay to be scared. Secondly, that there are two sides to everybody. Ironically, me being a scaredy cat turned me into a good leader. And that's how I found that place, and that's what motivated me to help others.
Czyli szczęście w nieszczęściu.
Tucker? He was a leader from the start, but he had an ugly side too. He killed those who opposed him. He was a real scumbag, but he was was my brother. He made me want to be a good person for the both of us. A hangover wasn't a high price to pay for that lesson.
What's the situation like in the shelter?
Not that great. People are getting nervous. A lot have already left, and even more plans.
Czekaj, jak tam Jennifer?
Even Mark and Laura saw him packing earlier.
And what about you?
Just the thought of running again is making me sick. Must be getting old. Plus, we got everything we could need right here. Where else would I go? Besides, I have faith that Baron would never let anything happen to this place. She's way too uptight about security.
Ej, ja w ogóle przecież ja miałem tego twojego boomboxa, czy jak to się nazywało.
Don't be shy, Rivers. Turn to see. I knew you.
Hell yeah. Oh, come on.
Sure, let's trust someone who gets called Dr. Death. That won't bite us in the ass. In the meantime, I'll see what I can learn from the new CPU we acquired from that infiltrator. This could be the breakthrough that we've all been waiting for. I need to concentrate, so please don't disturb me.
Dobra, idź sobie już. Hehehe. Ej, czemu nie mogę niczego zrobić?
Jacob. What's in your mind? Ever since you asked me about Peter, I can't stop thinking about him. Like a teenage girl. That's your fault, young man.
Have you tried looking for him?
I've looked for him for a while. I went to the place where we said we'd meet if we ever got separated. But he wasn't there. Maybe it's stupid. Maybe I should stop thinking about him. He's probably dead by now. God knows he can't take care of
him. Się nie ma 100% pewności, to trochę słabo.
Do you want to find him?
Sometimes I think I should drop everything and go. I would get an earful from Baron, but she's nothing I can't handle. Anyway, what I didn't tell you before is that during Judgment Day, I lost a child. Our child. I don't know if it would have happened anyway, but I like to blame the machines for that. I think that Peter felt with Taylor, we were given a second chance. God, he's still out there waiting for me, isn't he? Probably sitting in his rocking chair back in our house in Hollywood Hills. Oh. Where the hell are you, Peter?
Gdybym mógł, to bym pomógł, Erin.
Why do you think Skynet doesn't have their plants in the south?
Everyone's leaving. I think we should as well.
Yeah, but where to?
Szczerze powiedziawszy, gdyby się znalazł odpowiedni lider, który poprowadziłby grupę ludzi, którzy chcą opuścić ten teren, przypuszczam, że większość by odeszła. W tym momencie skąd pewność przypadkiem właśnie w tej grupce nie będzie infiltrator? Co prawda one wyglądają podobnie do siebie, ale niestety przerażenie przymyka oczy na wszelkie ewentualności. Tak potrzebuję. 5. A nie, 6 w sumie mogę sprzedać. Dobra. Na pewno przyda się rakieta. Hmm. Nie wiem, czy nie warto będzie raczej wziąć tej termolokacyjnej. Tylko, że termolokacyjna to wydaje mi się, że ona reaguje na temperaturę i też nie wiem, czy nie lepiej będzie po prostu naprowadzoną laserowo wziąć, bo w tym momencie bym sobie na przykład namierzył i wystrzelił w taki, powiedzmy, hunter, czyli myśliwiec Skynetu. No ale nie chcę za bardzo ryzykować. Dobra, poradzę sobie bez jeszcze, nie wiem, teraz. Poza tym to mam naprowadzone laserowo, okej. Nie wiem, czy ryzykować. W tej misji może sobie jednak jeszcze odpuszczę. Chyba mogę sprzedać. Strzelba chyba też nie jest mi jakoś specjalnie potrzebna. Zajmuje niepotrzebne miejsce. No i teraz w sumie jak mam 8600, to mógłbym kupić. Dobra, zaryzykuję. Mam 8 rakiet, więc jest ok. Trochę amunicji by się przydało tutaj jeszcze, bo straciłem troszeczkę. Wezmę 65. Dobra, niech będzie 64. Ok. Tak, i teraz generalnie zobaczyłbym jeszcze ulepszenia. Ulepszenia są trochę lepsze. Obrażenia na przykład mogę wziąć. Czemu to jest przewód przerwany? Obwód, znaczy... Aha, dobra, już rozumiem, bo to musi być tutaj. Teraz tak. No mogę znaleźć, będzie przerwany obwód, no dokładnie. Ale tutaj już jest okej. Czemu jest przerwany? Aha, musi być trójeczka. No to też będzie raczej przerwany obwód. Nieładnie. Głównie pod obrażenia. Dobra. Zobaczymy jeszcze, czy rakietę można ulepszyć. Nie można. O, ale właśnie, karabin snajperski. Karabin snajperski. Tu raczej najbardziej bym się skupiał pod damage'em. Tylko, że no to będzie obwód przerwany zaraz. A nie. To się można łączyć z pełnym, ok. O, ale tutaj będzie stabilność na przykład. Ewentualnie. Magazynek. Bo obrażenia, gdybym chciał trzasnąć, to da się trzasnąć na 8%. Same magazynki tu mam. Nie wiem, czy to się opłaca 8%. Lepiej chyba w stabilność zainwestować na przykład. Szybkostrzelność bez sensu. Dobra. Myślę, że będzie okej. Jennifer, gdzie jest? O, jest Jennifer.
Jacob, I didn't see you there.
Where's Patrick?
He's getting ready. I'm taking him with me. I figure it's time for him to see what's out there.
Is there something on your mind?
Actually, I have a secret to tell you. You have a fan. Patrick really looks up to you. It's good for him to have a role model. And I don't think he could have chosen better.
Thank you. It means a lot.
Are you kidding? It's the least I can do for helping us all this time. If you hadn't found us back in Pasadena, I don't know what would have happened. Well, actually I do. Exactly what the others said would happen. People were talking about the Annihilation Line months before it came. My father, of course, tried to turn it all into a joke.
But what did you think about it?
I didn't know what to think. Travelers would bring all sorts of gossip with them. But this kept coming back. When Patrick asked me if I was scared, I lied and said that I wasn't. You could feel the mood change at the house. The community my father tried to build started falling apart. Fewer and fewer people were coming by. And if they did, they weren't always friendly. We started to notice things going missing. Little things at first. People got nervous. And with time, it even got to my father.
Did it ever get to you?
Of course it did. For the first time in my life, there were only the three of us at the house. After a while, my father changed the sign from welcome to beware. He put a lock on the door. Started carrying a shotgun. I didn't even know he owned a gun. He always said he didn't believe in them. I wanted us to leave our house and run, but he didn't want to listen. Said it was the only place he could keep us safe. Thanks for letting me spill my guts like that.
Is everything okay? You seem far away.
Nothing can get past you, can it? I've been thinking about the day we met. I never told you how we really ended up there.
You can tell me anything.
I know I can. That's why you're the first person I'm telling this to. That day, loud hammering woke me up. When I came downstairs, I saw my father nailing the window shut. Through the crack, I saw them coming. Hundreds of metal heads and their red eyes. Even though they're just empty shells, I could feel the hate radiating from them.
What did you do?
I made Patrick stay upstairs and went back to talk to my father. We argued for a minute or two, and I tried to pull him away from the window. He pushed me away. I tried it again, but he shoved me. And this time I fell. I didn't recognize him as he was reaching for a shotgun. He said, I shouldn't worry about the machines, they wouldn't hurt us.
Ciekawe, czy był na liście Skynetu.
But the gun was already in my hands. I closed my eyes and went someplace else. Didn't even hear the shot. I didn't hear Patrick's steps either.
He saw you?
He did. He was staring at me like I was a stranger. He didn't scream or cry, he just stared. I threw the gun away, grabbed Patrick, and tried not to notice the hole in my father's unmoving chest. As we ran, I could hear them coming, so
zabiła swojego ojca.
Then you came. I wanted to tell someone about all this, but was afraid to.
I'm glad you did.
I am too. We talk a lot about how heartless the machines are. And I started to think that maybe I was too. I probably would have convinced myself of that if it wasn't for you keeping me sane. Thank you for everything. I never thought I would find a friend in times like these.
Where are you going?
I'm going out scavenging. Don't worry. I'm past thinking about running away. Knowing how much you'd miss me made me not want to leave.
No cóż. Fajnie by było jeszcze Patryka znaleźć, żeby sobie z nim porozmawiać. Ale chyba go się nie bardzo znajdę. Chociaż kto wie, że gdzieś się tu czai. No chyba raczej nie. Generalnie to był taki odcinek mówiony, więc jakby nie spojrzeć, kolejną częścią naszej podróży będzie Hollywood Hills. Dr. Edwin Mugg jest jedynym, który potrafi złamać zabezpieczenia Skynetu i umożliwić nam korzystanie z ich broni. Muszę udać się do Hollywood Hills i znaleźć mu karabin plazmowy drugiej generacji. I to będzie temat naszej kolejnej części odcinka, który już niebawem zawita na moim kanale. Dzięki wielkie za uwagę, za to, że mieliście cierpliwość, aby czytać to wszystko, co w tym odcinku się działo. Mało akcji, więcej gadania, ale niestety czasem i tak bywa. Do zobaczenia.